The U.S. economy is really hurting right now. If you don't believe me, just ask any politician who thinks that pretty soon we'll be chopping our neighbors up and using them for pot roast. But this isn't the first time the U.S. has faced this. We had a bad recession also in the early 90s. Yes, when George Herbert Walker Bush was president. I love this line.
Please, just give me a call back. It'll be a 5-minute conversation. It's very important. I need to talk to you. Okay? Thanks. Bye. All right, where was I? Oh yeah, the year, 1991. There was a recession going on in the United States, similar to the one going on right now. However, one Florida-based company dared to dream, and it was a very bold dream. That company, Active Enterprises. The game? Action 52. Why did you stay out of it, Rob? Ooh, a mom joke. That's real funny coming from someone who doesn't even have any legs. Ooh, look at me. I can walk and run. What can you do? Stupid robot.
Action 52 was an unlicensed multi-cart game developed by Active Enterprises, a Florida-based electronics company. This was an ambitious game to say the least. 52 games on one cart? All original releases? Come on. This game had a suggested retail price of $199. That would come out to little less than $4 a game. Back then, Active Enterprises saw this as a deal, but remember this. In today's currency value, that's approximately $18,000. But it looks promising from the box art. You have a ninja, dragon, an eyeball thingy, and this horrified kid looks like he's about to be killed. Sorry, son, you picked the wrong game today. You should have went for something safe like Mappy Land or City Connection. And to put the icing on the cake, this game was made in America. That's right, during the recession, people were all gung-ho about buying American and not foreign stuff. Okay, let's open this box up and see exactly what Active Enterprises has in store. You've got your sleeve with the quality assurance right on there, a manual, mine's beat up, a read before using card, and a comic. Let's take a look at the actual game card. Notice anything? It's actually clear, enabling you to see the ROM board and circuitry. It's hard to tell if Active Enterprises made this decision because the carts were cheaper to make this way, or they wanted to be cool. Even if it's cheap, it's pretty cool that you can tell if the connectors are dirty or not just by looking at the game. Then there's the comic, based upon the heroes of one of the games, Cheetahmen. Active Enterprises wanted to turn Cheetahmen into a franchise, much like the Ninja Turtles or even Battletoads. Take a look at the comic's back. There's an advertisement for toys that would be coming soon. Do you think these were actually released? You might as well mold them out of Play-Doh because it's not happening, little boys and girls. And speaking of children, look at this pedophile staring at us. Oof.
Well, let's take a look at the comic.
Okay, first page. Oh, look at the cute little cheetah. Oh my god! Are you kidding me? The first page of your comic has a cheetah getting shot through the chest with a freaking exit wound?
What the hell, man? I'm not the most politically correct person, but come on, there's 7-year-olds that are reading this.
Why don't we just include a comic with Ninja Turtles that has Shredder raping Splinter with his own walking stick?
Okay, I know Action 52 has an absolutely terrible reputation, but that's not going to stop me. I'm going to look for the positive in this. There's got to be at least one good game out of 52. And I'll keep playing until I find that one. Or until my sister calls me back so I can cry to her about Allison dumping me. But anyway, I'm neither angry nor irate, but I'm going to play and get through this. Oh yes.